here in Winooski at the Heritage Winooski Mill Museum for an art exhibit. Yes, an art exhibit during the pandemic. And it's called David McCauley, Building a Mill Town. It's based on David McCauley's 1983 book, Mill, which is about a fictional mill town. But once you start looking around, here in the historic Winooski Mill District, you're gonna see a lot of things you recognize.
I think when people go through Mill and look at those images, they say, oh, that's such and such. And in a way, they're right.
And what I love is I just looked at a lot of these drawings and I thought, oh my God, this looks like the Champlain Mill.
What's great about this exhibit is that we're in a mill building, not unlike what's being depicted in the drawings. And so we can look at the pictures, read some of the text, and then turn around, and here it is.
We tell the story of the history of the mills in this area and the people who worked there.
We will provide a printable map where you could walk around the riverfront and see some sites along the way as well.
We took a walk around the Winooski and Burlington mills with David a few months ago.
And I have been writing books now for about 40 years. I have a degree in architecture. I've always drawn or made models of things. Innate curiosity and sort of how things work. Basically have been able to do what I really love to do. I discovered that it wasn't that I didn't like architecture, I just didn't want to have to build it, except on paper. I like having an exhibition like we're doing here at the mill, where you can see some of the process. And this is looking like down the river at the waterfall and so on.
I've been interested in David's work since I was a little boy, 8 or 9 years old, when my parents gave me some of his early books.
I have still my childhood copies of The Way Things Work and Cathedral, how people make things and how that impacts the community and the landscape.
And then you look across the river at the Chase Mill and you see, you know, down along the river, oh, there's an arch. Yeah. You start making connections, and I think that's what it's really all about, is just understanding the built environment. And everything exists for a reason, and so this helps explain why and how they came into being.
It was going to these sites, it was going to these mills, it was walking through them. It was walking around a site where there used to be a mill. Remnants of arches, I mean, thank goodness that arches are so structurally stable, they stand forever. It makes looking at these buildings not like looking at, you know, dull old factories, I use that phrase intentionally, because these are magnificent structures. The fact that we're still in one, you know, it's just an example of you know, the permanence of these things.
I think it's really easy for people to take for granted the things around us because we see them every day, and David's work, I think, really makes you stop and think about how amazing it is that people can think up these structures and actually build them.
For me, drawing is seeing, because you really do get to know your subject. Use what's available to get people looking more carefully at things around them so that they develop an understanding that really supports the attachment they probably already have.
I can't think of Winooski without the mills. That's what makes Winooski a place. And when you see a big mill building, you automatically kind of know a little bit of the history of the community. You know, it was an industrial town at one point, and there were probably immigrant workers coming to work in the mills. The mill is kind of the keystone for a much larger story of the history of Winooski.
Rivers are fascinating, right, and powerful, and mills are these huge, you know, large buildings. I think they just symbolize sort of human ingenuity. I work in this building. I haven't set foot in this building since March until I came here to check out the exhibit. So this is just a really neat and accessible way to see something and feel connected to the community.
David is also able to capture these little human moments, and it just drives home that kind of everyday nature of the people who built these structures.
And they start to notice things in their own lives, around them. They start to maybe notice other architecture. All because I bothered to take the time to take something apart and then put it back together in a way that would make accessible all the information behind it.
We're kind of reaching that point where that older generation who was the last one to work in the mills is no longer here. So I think this is a great way to re-engage and remind these newer populations of what this is all about and why it's important to Winooski's heritage.
This exhibit is part of Vermont Curators Group 2020 Vision Project. We are a participant along with 47 other museums. I really encourage you to check it out.
And if it stirs even a little bit more interest in our history. It will have done its job.
David McCauley's show is here through March 12th. It's free, but you need to get timed tickets on their website. Wishing you all very happy and safe holidays. We will get stuck in Vermont with you again real soon.
I've done enough of like these literally for you where I'm like, okay. I think I know how to like, I know how to just talk. Say, yes.
And my glasses are foggy.